Welcome to Reality Create a Video. I'm Hermes, and today we're going to cover how to make titanium from start to finish. All right, here we got a beaker of titanium, 500 milliliters of titanium. And I've already cooked it, but we're going to go through how to make it. Now, titanium is good for building strength, muscle, things like that. I've found titanium responds well if you're working out. So if you're doing weights, whatever muscle you're using, it seems the titanium kind of goes in there and augments that process and creates muscle much faster. I guess about that's the primary thing that I've found beneficial to me with titanium. And I'll post a little thing up there about other stuff that titanium is supposed to be good for. So titanium, now it's one of the more trickier metals to make. It requires the gold formula, okay, which is corn syrup, NaCl, and sodium citrate. And that requires you to make stock solutions of the stuff. And as I've pointed out in my previous, like my gold video and my stainless steel video, you have to get some sea salt or NaCl, no iodine. Could be regular table salt, just no iodine. And you have to dissolve 1.5 grams in 500 milliliters of water to give you the first chemical that you're going to need. And the second chemical you're going to need is sodium citrate. And you're going to make a stock solution for that too. So you're going to dissolve 7.35 grams in 500 milliliters of water to make that. And then you need corn syrup, which is just a stabilizer. You could actually not use corn syrup if you don't want to, but it tends to come out better with a little corn syrup. So you're going to get corn syrup. You're going to put 30 milliliters of corn syrup in here, and then 20 milliliters of distilled water. Mix it all together, and that gives you a corn syrup mix that you can actually use in a dropper. And that's the materials that we're going to need. You're going to need a power supply. I use 37.5 volts. Anything, I suppose, above 24 volts will work fine. You're going to need a stirrer or some kind of agitation going on in here. Of course, you're going to need your rods. You only need one rod, okay? I use a carbon rod for, there's an anode and a cathode, which sits, well, I don't have the top on, okay? But you guys, if you've watched my videos, you've seen it. It's the top. And I use a carbon rod for the anode. Now, the anode never loses material. Never, ever, ever. The anode is like the thing that pulls the material off of the other rod. And it entices it to go into the solution. And hopefully it makes it into the solution before it attaches to the carbon rod. And that goes in there on the anode side like that. And then the cathode side, which is the positive of the power supply, is going to get titanium. Now, there's two pieces of titanium here. This one has never been used, and this one I've used to cook this batch. And I'm going to show you a close-up of what it looks like after it's cooked. It's like a battle zone, the titanium, or it gets all oxidized, okay? And I've tried to sand this stuff off, and it doesn't work. So, you know, best I could tell you is that you will get maybe 3 or 4 uses out of this titanium rod before it breaks apart. It gets brittle from the oxidation. And then you'll need a new piece because, like I said, titanium, actually in the lab, they recommend sandblasting it clean. Now, this is an 18-gauge piece of titanium. It's quite thin. I would not get anything thinner than an 18-gauge. In fact, I went online to Amazon to see if this 18-gauge, which comes in a spool, this is a 25-foot spool. I think it was about $30 on Amazon. The 18-gauge right now is not available on Amazon. The best you could do is they have a 14-gauge for $30. I would not go, like I said, any smaller than 18 gauge. So 14 gauge should be fine. And the reason I wouldn't go any smaller than that is because you're going to be wasting a lot of material. These little thin rods, like I said, I get maybe two or three or four uses out of this before it's unusable anymore. If you had anything smaller than 18 gauge, you're probably only going to get one use out of it. But it's 25 feet of the stuff. All right, at 6 inches a piece, you're looking at, if you're only getting one use out of it, say you were doing it for personal use, and you weren't supplying the whole neighborhood like I am, you could get away with a 22 gauge piece of titanium and throw it away afterwards. You'd get, 25 feet, 6 inches a piece, figure it out, 50 batches out of it, which I guess isn't too bad if you think about that. So, if you're mass producing it, other than yourself, get a thicker piece of titanium. If not, you can go with the smaller pieces of titanium. So, this batch here took 40 minutes to cook. Anyway, this goes in there like that. Okay, you're going to put the negative of the supply on here. This has already been cooked, so I'm not going to actually cook it, but let me show you. Negative of supply here goes on my carbon rod. Now, if you don't have a carbon rod, you can use a copper rod. Copper rod works fine. The reason I use a carbon rod is because the carbon is more energetic. I get more energy in a carbon rod, and it helps to cook the colloidals more completely and faster. So that's why I've switched to carbon. But if you don't have carbon, you can use copper. This is a picture of that titanium right there. You'll see it. It's a nice-looking colloidal. This took 40 minutes to cook. You can weigh the rod if you have a three-digit scale. But basically, you can't actually see this, but there's a very faint, milky color to this. And that's about it. It doesn't change any color or anything like that. You just get this light, milky color, and then after you reach this light milky color, no more stuff goes into the fluid. What happens is you'll get a lot of white flakes floating around. And titanium hydroxide is white, so you'll get white flakes floating around in here, and if you continue to cook it past the 40 minutes, let's say, you're just going to get more white flakes in there. You're not going to get any more material in there. If that's just going to be material that can no longer become a colloidal. So it starts clumping together into larger pieces of titanium hydroxide, which then you're going to have to filter out with your filters. And I always recommend, you always have to filter your colloidals. Yeah, and I have two systems. One is these nice little funnels I printed up. And I put the little coffee filter, the small coffee filter in here. And I will take this, put that in there, and I will pour the beaker into here, and that will filter very nicely for my stuff. This is takes a little bit of time to filter, so my other filtration method, which actually I like, is a little bigger. See this jar? Okay, this is an old coffee thing from a coffee machine. So I put that big filter in here, the little hole down here, goes in here, and I will dump the whole beaker in here, and it's got a lot of surface area on this coffee filter, and it drains quite quickly. Okay, final thoughts on titanium. If you don't have a three-digit scale, just cook it for 40 minutes, 500 milliliters of water, and then you add these materials. You do not need any heat, okay? Unlike gold, which requires 90 degrees C, do not cook titanium with heat. It's not needed. You can if you want to, but you do not need to use heat. The gold formula will strip the titanium off rather aggressively, even without the heat. So that's about it. That is how to cook titanium start to finish. You can review some of my other start-to-finish videos. Each one I reveal different little things in there that I may not have revealed here. It's hard for me to keep track of all the little things that go into making this stuff, but if you watch a few of those start to finish videos, you will get the idea of what you need to do to cook the various stuff and titanium in general. I'm Hermes. This is Reality Creator Video, and I will talk to you again soon.